Welcome to the Kroc Junior Theater Workshop production of the best Christmas pageant ever. My name is Heidi and I'm one of the 34 young actresses in the cast. We have worked hard over the past 8 weeks to put on this 50-minute production and are thrilled you are here to enjoy our work. If you and your child had as much fun as I did, please join us this spring for The Lion King. More information can be found in your program. Or you can talk to Mr. Sean or Ms. Glynis after the show. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy the best Christmas pageant ever.
The Herdmans were the worst kids in the whole history of the world. They lied and stole, even the girls, and talked dirty and hit little kids and took the name of the Lord in vain and set fire to Fred Shoemaker's old broken down tool house.
And that's not all. Somebody sent 5 dozen donuts to the firemen, and the Herdmans ate them all. And what they couldn't eat, they stuffed down their pockets and down the front of their shirts.
And they wrote this really, really dirty word on the back of Naomi Waddle's favorite turtle. So now Naomi can't take it to the YMCA pet show. Her mother won't let her.
What was the word?
Oh. And that's not all. They did it with fluorescent paint, so it glows in the dark. When you can't even see the turtle, you can still see the word.
And they put a whole bunch of tadpoles in the school drinking fountain. And Miss Barnes swallowed 2 or 3 by mistake. Someone yelled, "Mildred, stop! You're drinking tadpoles!" But it was too late.
Did she get sick?
Not right away.
And that's not all. There were 7 of them. Ralph, Imogene, Leroy, Claude, Ollie, Jenny, and Gladys, and they went around the Wildrow Wilson School like those South American fish that'll strip your bones clean. And they went around town the same way, stealing things and whamming things and tearing things up. So it was hard to get away from them. There was only one safe place.
Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, because there are no Herdmans there, but Jesus loves us, as they say, because he keeps them miles away.
That's my little brother, Charlie. That's what he said when the Sunday school teacher asked him what his favorite thing about church was. Charlie said, "No Herdmans." And that made all the teachers mad because all the other kids said nice things about God and Jesus and good feeling. But old Charlie told the real truth, no Herdmans.
I don't care what everybody else said. All that other stuff is okay, but the main good thing about church is that the Herdmans aren't there, ever.
That doesn't seem like a very Christian sentiment to me.
It's a very practical sentiment. Charlie was all black and blue last week because he had to sit next to Leroy Herman in school.
Is he the worst one? Leroy?
They're all the worst ones.
Ralph's the biggest, so Ralph gets you.
That doesn't make a difference. Gladys isn't big, but she's fast and she's mean and she bites.
Just forget I asked. Just stay away from all of them.
That's what I said. Stay away from them. Go to church.
I'm glad to hear you feel that way.
Why?
No arguments about this year's Christmas pageant.
I don't want to be a shepherd again.
Tell Miss Armstrong that you want to be the wise man.
I don't want to be in it.
Everybody's in it. Think how I feel sitting there on Christmas Eve if my own children were in the pageant. Think how your father would feel. You'd feel terrible, wouldn't you, Bob?
Well. Actually, I didn't plan to go, you always know how crowded it always is. They could use my seat. I'll just stay home, relax, put on my back. But they never change anything in the Christmas pageant.
Well, there's gonna be something different this year.
What is it?
Charlie's gonna be wearing your bathrobe.
You just made that up, Grace.
Why don't you be Joseph? Elmer Hopkins will pay you $1 to be Joseph. Elmer's sick of being Joseph all the time, just because his father's the minister. Nobody wants to be Joseph.
Nobody wants to be in it.
What are you going to be this year?
I'm always in the angel choir.
Why can't Charlie be in the angel choir?
Because I can't sing.
Well, from what I've heard, that's actually not a serious drawback. A warrior in the manger always sounds like a closet full of mice, in my opinion.
What do you wear in the angel choir?
Bed sheets.
Oh boy, some choice, a bathrobe or a bed sheet. Come on, let's go watch TV.
Miss Armstrong works very hard to give everyone a lovely experience.
Oh, Mom.
Miss Armstrong just likes to run things. They're right, of course. She directs the pageant. She's in charge of the supper. She's the chairman of the bazaar. I think Helen Armstrong would preach the sermon if anyone wrote the letter.
Wait, is that George Armstrong's wife?
Yeah.
Well, maybe she'll try to manage the hospital because that's where she is. I saw George at the drugstore. He told me his wife broke her leg this morning. She'll be in charge for 2 weeks and laid up till the first of the year.
The first of the year? Well, they'll have to cancel Christmas.
Wait. She's in charge of Christmas?
Well, she's in charge of the pageant. She's in charge of the supper. I feel so sorry for Helen, but who's going to do all those things?
Yes, I'll bring the potluck supper. I'll bring the potluck supper around the world. We'll do about this pageant. Alas, how about Grace?
I just can't, Edna. I've got company all Christmas week. How about Grace?
Yeah, how about Grace?
Hello? Grace?
Bob!
What?
I have to direct the Christmas pageant.
Does that mean I have to go?
Our Christmas pageant isn't what you'd call four-star entertainment. Miss Armstrong breaking her leg was the only unexpected thing that ever happened to it. It's always the same old Christmas story, and the same old carols, and the same old Mary and Joseph. And that's what my mother was stuck with. That and Mrs. Armstrong.
Well, I'll tell you again, Grace, how fortunate is it to have a Mary too? Here's why I always tell her Mary. I tell her unless she's a Mary, carefully because she is the mother of Jesus.
I know that, Helen.
Yes, then I tell them about Joseph. And how important he was, and that was God's choice to be Jesus' father. And I always tell them, I never do explain much about Joseph because it's always Elmer Hopkins and he knows all about Mary and Joseph.
I thought Mrs. Armstrong was in traction. How can she talk on the phone if she's in traction?
What do you think traction is?
Like when they put you to sleep?
Well, no such luck. Grace, I think we need salt, pepper, and napkins.
But I do explain about the wise men and the shepherds and how important they are. And I tell them there are no small parts, only small actors. Remind the angel choir not to stare at the audience and don't let them wear earrings or things like that. Don't let them wear clunky shoes or high heels. I just hope you don't have too many baby angels, Grace, because they're your biggest problem.
You'll save some for the rest of us, won't you, Charlie?
I'm hungry. Leroy Herdman stole my lunch again.
How can you let him do that to you, day after day?
How can I stop him? Where's the chicken?
Grace, where's the chicken?
It's still in the oven.
I'll get it.
We'll have to get somebody to push the baby angels on, or otherwise they'll get in each other's way, and they'll bend their wings. Bob could do that. He could also keep an eye on the shepherds, too.
And another thing about the angel choir. Don't let them wear lipstick because they think it's a play.
Bing bong! Helen, I have to go. There's someone at the door.
And yes, tell them that it looks terrible. So tell them.
Bing bong! Someone's at my door, Helen. I have to go. I'm coming.
Lady, can you get me some supper? I haven't had a straight meal in 3 days.
Oh, for heaven's sakes.
Well, I was actually very lonely at the dinner table.
I guess Helen's lonely at the hospital.
Not unless the phones are still working.
I bet she told you about no small parts, only small actors.
And getting somebody to shove the baby angels on and make the shepherds shut up?
Yeah, she suggested that to your father.
Does that mean I have to go?
And Grace, don't just use anybody for baby Jesus. Get a quiet one. Better yet, get two of them, if you can, so that if one turns out to be fussy, you can always switch them.
My mother didn't pay much attention to Mrs. Armstrong. She said Mrs. Armstrong was stuck in the hospital with nothing to do but think of problems, and there weren't going to be any problems. Of course, she didn't count on the Herdmans. That was Charlie's fault.
Leroy, you give me back my lunch.
You're kidding. Here.
You stole my dessert again.
How did you know? Because it isn't there?
What was it?
Two Twinkies?
Oh, yeah. That's what it was.
Hey, you think it's so great to steal
you my dessert every day? Well, I don't care. I'll even give you my dessert. I get all the dessert I want in Sunday school.
What kind of dessert?
All kinds. Chocolate cake and candy bars and cookies and Twinkies and Big Wheels. We get refreshments all the time we want.
You're a liar.
And ice cream and donuts and cupcakes.
And who gives it to you?
The minister.
Why? Is he crazy?
No, I think he's rich.
That was the wrong thing to tell the Herdmans, because the very next Sunday, there they were in Sunday school, just in time to hear about the Christmas pageant.
What's a pageant?
It's a play.
Like on TV? What's it about?
It's about Jesus.
Everything here is.
And it's about Mary. Well, mostly it's about Mary.
Who's Mary?
I am. Well, probably. I know the part.
Come on, Beth, Charlie, you remember to come. Now, this won't take very long if you all settle down. Today, we're going to be deciding who will play our main roles in our Christmas pageant. But, of course, everyone will have an important part to play. You know what Miss Arkstrom always tells you?
There are no small parts, only small actors.
Isn't that what Miss Armstrong always tells you?
That's what she says, but she never says what it means.
Don't you know what that means?
I know what it means. It means the short kids have to be in the front row of the angel choir, or else nobody can see them.
Well, not exactly. It really means that the littlest baby angel is just as important as Mary.
I don't think that anybody is as important as Mary.
Well, naturally, that's what you think, Alice. I think Jesus is more important.
I still think it means the short kids have to be in the front row.
Girls, girls, everyone's important. Mary, Jesus, and the short kids. Our angels. So please remind your mothers that you'll need bed sheets. People on the angel choir will need bed sheets too. And if any of you have old bathrobes at home, Hobie, did you have a question?
No, I just wanted to say that I can't be a wise man. We're going to Pennsylvania.
Why didn't you say that sooner?
I just remembered.
Why not?
I don't know. Just to be a shepherd.
I am not going to be a shepherd.
Oh, yes, you are. What's the matter with all of you? Why don't you want to volunteer?
I don't want to be a shepherd. Gladys Herdman hits too hard.
Gladys is going to hit anybody. Of course, the angel of the Lord just goes and tells that Jesus was born.
And hits them.
Elmer, that's ridiculous. Now I don't want to hear anything from any of you, from anyone. No shepherds can get sick or quit. May quit or get sick. Now you can go, but I expect to see everyone here on Wednesday at 6:30. Alice, what's the matter with you? Why don't you raise your hand?
I don't know.
You don't know? Alice, I expected you.
Miss Bradley, get Gladys off of me.
To volunteer for the park.
Miss Bradley.
Oh, come on, Alice. Let them down.
I didn't dare raise my hand. Imogene would have killed me. She said, I'm going to be Marion in the Christmas pageant. And if you open your mouth or raise your hand, you'll wish you did. And I said, but I'm always Marion in the Christmas pageant. And she said, go ahead then. And next spring, when the pussy willows come out, I'll stick one so far down your ear that no one can reach it. And it'll sprout there and grow and grow. And you'll spend the rest of your life with the pussy willow bush growing out of your ear.
You know she wouldn't do that.
She would too. Hermans would do anything. You just watch. They'll do something terrible and ruin the whole Christmas pageant. And it's all your mother's fault.
Wait, what?
Jane, Edna McCarthy, did you hear about the... Well, it must be Grace's fault somehow. How else would the six of them end up in a Christmas pageant when they all ought to be in jail?
Vera, Irma, Slocum, I just heard that Imogene Herdman is going to be marrying the Christmas pageant. And I? Is that bad to all six of them? Vera, I live next door to that outfit, and I'd rather live next door to a zoo. Has Grace gone crazy?
Where did they come from? Who lived them in? Imogene Herdman, what kind of child is that to be the mother of Jesus? He was what? Visiting a shut-in? Well, I'm a shut-in. He wasn't visiting me.
I said, why don't you let them hand out programs at the door? Grace said we never have programs for the pageant, but I said...
Better nail that church, lock up the silver service, and hide the collection plates before they clean all out. I mean, what's the matter with Grace? Couldn't you have sent them away or tell them to go home?
Because you know that what the Herdmans would do.
Oh, I'd be responsible. If I'd been up and around, this would have never happened.
If I'd been up and around, this would never would have happened.
Let me tell you.
Don't tell me. I'm on your side. The car's over there.
Helen Armstrong isn't the only woman alive who can run a Christmas pageant. I made up my mind and I did the best I could under the circumstances. And I'm gonna make this the best Christmas pageant ever. And I'm gonna do it with the Hermans. And they were the only ones who raised their hands. They were the only one who volunteered. And I don't care if...
Good for you, Grace. The car's over there.
And you're gonna help me.
Oh my God, does that mean...
You have to go. And the shepherds come and gather around the manger.
Where'd all these shepherds come from anyway? What's an inn?
It's like a motel where people go to spend the night.
What people? Jesus?
Oh, honestly, Jesus wasn't even born yet. Mary and Joseph went there.
Why?
To pay their taxes.
At a motel? Shut up, Ollie. Everybody shut up. I want to hear her. Begin at the beginning.
The beginning?
The beginning of the play. What happens first?
Imogene, this is a Christmas story from the Bible. Haven't you ever heard the Christmas story from the Bible? Well, this is what we're doing, a Christmas pageant, so I better be useful.
I don't believe that, do you? That they never heard of the Christmas story?
Why not? They don't even know what the Bible is, and they've never gone to church in their entire dumb brother told them we have refreshments. Now we have to waste all this time for nothing.
All right, now. There went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And Joseph went up to the galley with Mary, his wife, being raped with child.
Pregnant. She was pregnant.
All right, we all knew that Mary was pregnant, and it came to pass while they were there that the days were accomplished and that she should be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son.
I don't think it's very nice to say Mary was pregnant.
Well, she was.
I don't think your mother should say Mary was pregnant. It's better to say, great with child.
And wrapped him up in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, so, because there was no room at the inn.
You mean they tied him up and put him in a feed box? What was the child welfare?
The child welfare is in our house every 5 minutes.
There wasn't any child welfare in Bethlehem.
I'll say there wasn't.
All right. And wrapped him up in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room. Nobody knew that the baby was going to be Jesus.
Didn't Mary know? Didn't he know? What was the matter with Joseph that he didn't tell them her pregnant and everything?
What's a manger? Some kind of bed?
Well, they didn't have a bed, so Mary had to use whatever there was. What would you do if you had a newborn baby and no bed to put it in?
We put Gladys in a drawer.
Well, there you are. You didn't have a bed, so you had to use something else.
Oh, we had a bed. Only Ollie was still in and we wanted to get out. He didn't like Gladys. Remember how you didn't like Gladys?
That was pretty smart, Ollie, not to like Gladys right off the bat.
A manger is a large feeding trough for animals.
What were the wadded up clothes?
The what?
Says it in there. She wrapped him up in wadded up clothes.
Swaddling clothes. People used to wrap babies up in big pieces of material so they could feel cozy.
You mean they tied him up and put him in a feed box? Where was the child welfare?
Child welfare is at our house every 5 minutes.
Yeah!
And there were shepherds keeping watch over the flock by night, and lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them in the glory of
Shazam!
What?
Out of the black night, with horrible vengeance, the mighty Marvel.
I don't know what you're talking about, Clarice.
In Amazing Comics, the mighty Marvel comes out of the black night with horrible vengeance.
This is the angel of the Lord who comes to the shepherds.
Who comes out of nowhere, right? In the black night, right?
Well, in a way.
Shazam!
Now, when Jesus was born, there came wise men from the east, bringing gifts of gold and frankincense.
What's that?
And myrrh.
What's that?
They were special things, spices and precious oils.
Oil? What kind of present is oil? We get better presents from the child.
Were the welfare the wise men?
They were kings and they were sent.
Well, it's about time somebody important showed up. If they're kings, they can get the baby out of the barn and tell the innkeeper where to get off.
They were sent by Herod, who was the main king, and he wanted to find Jesus and put him to death.
My God, he just got born. They're going to kill a baby.
Who's Herod in this play?
There isn't a Herod in this play.
He's out to kill the baby? He's not even in the play?
Well, somebody better be Herod. Let Charlie be Herod. And he says, go get me that baby, and they say okay because he's a king and all.
But then they don't do it. They go back and get him.
I am not going to be Herod.
Forget about Herod. No one's going to be Herod.
And I run away with the baby till the fight's over.
Somebody ought to fix the innkeeper. Gladys, you fix out the innkeeper.
I can't. I'm an angel.
So, I wouldn't just hang out.
Well, I wouldn't just hang out in the barn. I'd get a room.
She said there wasn't any room.
Then I'll kick somebody out. I'd tell them it's the middle of winter and I've got this baby, so either get out or move over.
I dropped her from there.
I just sent an angel after him. She could just point her electric finger at him and he'd turn into a pile of ashes.
Yeah! Zap!
Never said.
Christmas pageant.
No,
down the FBI files. At least they picked out the right villain. It was Herod they wanted to gang up on and not the baby Jesus. But the baby Jesus quit the pageant anyways. It was supposed to be Eugene Slocum, but Mrs. Slocum said she didn't want Imogene Herdman getting her hands on him. So we didn't have a baby, and that bothered my mother, and she kept trying to scratch one up, even at the last rehearsal. What's that you're writing in?
It's like a diary.
No, it's not. It's all about the Herdmans. Imogene curses and swears all the time. Ralph talks about naughty things. Mrs. Bradley called Mary pregnant. Gladys drinks communion wine. It's not wine, it's grape juice.
I don't care what it is. She drinks it. I've seen her 3 times with her mouth all purple. They steal too. If you shake the birthday bank, it doesn't make one sound because they stole every last penny out of it.
And you wrote all this down, what for?
For my mom, and Reverend Hopkins, and the Ladies Aid Society, and anybody else who wants to know what happened when the whole Christmas pageant turns out to be a big mess.
All right, let's go quiet. Beth, will you and Alice please come up here so we can get started? Now, this is our last rehearsal, and we're going to... You had a new baby brother?
No, he's not new. He's 4 years old. Yeah. He's double jointed and he could probably scrunch up.
I'll get us a baby.
How can you do that?
There's always 2 or 3 babies in carriages outside the supermarket. I'll get one of them.
Imogene, you can't just walk off with somebody's baby. Well, we'll just use a doll.
That's better anyway. Dolls don't bite you.
Imogene, you know Mary doesn't wear ear tips.
I have to wear these. I got my ears pierced, and I don't keep something in them. They'll grow together.
Well, I don't think they would grow in an hour and a half. What did the doctor tell you to do?
What doctor?
Well, who pierced your ears?
Gladys.
She probably did it with an ice pick. I'll bet Imogene's ears turn black and fall off.
Well, find something smaller. Now, is that your costume? Is that what you're gonna wear? You're all supposed to be in costume.
I forgot my halo.
My wings got open. And Janet's got my robe.
My mom doesn't own any white sheets. Can I wear sheets with balloons on it?
Shepherd before.
You have to wear your father's bathrobe. That's what I have to do. Mm-hmm.
He doesn't own a bathrobe.
What does he hang around the house in?
His underwear.
Alright, pretend that you're wearing your costumes.
Are we going through the whole thing?
Yes, of course, but we're going to practice the entrances, so if all of you can go where you're supposed to be, and we'll start with the shepherds. Just read from the last word, Maxine.
Flocks keeping watch over the shepherds keeping watch over their flocks by night.
Music, shepherds.
And an angel of the Lord appeared to them and
Sam!
No, Gladys!
Out of the black night!
No! Go on, Maxine.
A multitude of the heavenly hosts.
Is it white men?
why then?
I'm not a baby. Don't touch him. I named him Jesus.
No. You don't say anything. Mary doesn't say anything. No one says anything. Mary or Joseph.
Did start over, and we never did go over the whole thing. Those 5 minutes turned into 15 minutes, and Imogene Herdman spent the whole time lighting fires in the ladies' room. Then Miss McCarthy came in and saw the smoke, and called the fire department, and they came right away.
Fire! There's a fire!
Take the big hose from the side.
The place is full of kids.
Get the kids out!
Somewhere on the first floor.
They cleared everybody out of the building and dragged a hose through the church looking for a fire to put out. But the only one they found was in the kitchen. All the applesauce cake burned out. Of course, all the ladies were mad about this, and Miss McCarthy was mad. And my mother was mad.
Why in the world did you call the fire department about a little smoke?
It was a lot of smoke. The ladies' room was full of thick smoke.
Wendelkin's mother was mad too, and Reverend Hopkins said he didn't know what to think. All the ladies' aid society was mad too also.
I've been on the telephone all day, and I can't make a head or tails. Some people say they set fire to the ladies' room. Some people say they set fire to the kitchen.
That was Hobie Clark talking about his underwear, and they didn't set fire to anything. The only fire was in the kitchen when the applesauce cake was burned up.
The whole church is in uproar.
I don't know.
Jesus said, suffer the little children to come up to me. But I don't think he meant the Herdmans.
Grace, don't you think we should cancel the pageant?
I bet that was Helen Armstrong's idea.
We could blame it on the fire. Makes a good excuse.
I bet that was Helen McCarthy's idea.
Everyone thinks it's going to be a
disaster? Well, it's not. It's going to be the best Christmas pageant ever.
But Grace, I don't think anyone will come to see it.
I didn't think so either, and neither did Charlie. But boy, were we wrong. On Christmas Eve, the church was jam full. Everybody came to see what the Herdmans would do.
Wait until the lights are on. Now, watch your step.
I can't even see where I'm going. I don't know what you expect to do with that thing.
I thought it might look like a palm tree. Now that I look at it, it doesn't. I have no idea what's going to happen tonight. We haven't even
to run through it all the way. This might be the first time that the Christmas pageant has ever had a Joseph, like, that ever had a, where Joseph and the wise men had a fight over Mary, and Mary runs away with the baby. The Hermans think it's some sort of spy story?
Well, all the kids in the world are in the basement putting on bed sheets.
I mean, our kids?
We're here.
Well, go get your costumes on.
It's just going to be awful, you know. They look like trick-or-treat, all dirty and fastened together with safety pins and wearing their moldy old sneakers. Mary and Joseph, I mean. They look like refugees or something.
Well, that's actually what they kind of were. Because Mary and Joseph were kind of like refugees. They were a long way from home, they had no place to stay. They didn't know anybody, and they were probably cold and hungry. And, well, yeah, messy.
I don't know about cold and hungry, but they're sure messy.
Oh dear, do you think I should?
I think you worry way too much. So, I'm going to push the baby angels on, shush the shepherds and give them their crooks, and push them on stage. When do I do that?
Just follow the script.
Well, baby shepherd, babies, angels, shepherds, wise men. I don't see where the fire engines come in.
Is everyone here? Ben, I want you and Alice to stand right here. Gladys, where's your halo? Unto a child is born, and that's it. Now let's all go backstage, and remember to be quiet, everyone, and good luck.
Mrs. Bradley, actors don't say good luck. Actors say regalet.
Well, some people might get the wrong idea. And Imogene, try to remember it's a baby, and for tonight, anyways, it's Jesus.
In the days of Caesar Augustus, a decree went out that all the world should be taxed. And Joseph went into Bethlehem with Mary and his wife, who was great with child. And while they were there, she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Look at them! Aren't they awful? What's she doing with the baby?
Oh, I don't think it's very nice to birth the baby Jesus as if he had a colic.
Well, he could have had colic just like any other baby.
I don't care. It looks awful. And they look awful.
So what? They just came a long way and now they don't have any place to sleep.
Plus, they've got a new baby to worry about.
Who? Ralph and Imogen?
No, Mary and Joseph.
And in that region, there were shepherds in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them. The glory of the Lord shone round about, and they were sore afraid when the angel of the Lord appeared to them and said,
Hey! Unto you a child is born, and his name is Jesus. He's in a barn. Go see him. Come on, he's over there.
And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men. When Jesus was born, there came wise men from the east to worship him, bringing gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh.
They are awful too. And what's that wee voice got?
It's a hiccup.
their own ham? They must hate ham.
Well, even if they hate ham, it's the only thing they've ever given away in their whole life.
Being warned in a dream that they should not return to their own country, the wise men departed another way. The shepherds also departed, praising God for all that they had seen and heard. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. I like that. How about the spirit? Sometimes you can't even hear the angel of the Lord, and I must go find Grace to tell her.
Oh, I just wish that Irma would have let her have mentioned to be the baby Jesus.
Who was the baby Jesus?
Why, it was a doll.
Oh, I don't think that was a doll.
Well, it did seem real.
It did seem real, as if it might have happened just that way. We all thought the pageant was about Jesus, but that was only part of it. It was about a new mother and father who are in a whole lot of trouble. No money, no place to go, no doctor, nobody they knew. And then arriving from the east, like my uncle from New Jersey, some rich friends. Because of the Herdmans, it was a whole new story. Imogene burping the baby, the wise men bringing such a sensible present. After all, they couldn't eat frankincense. And even Gladys, he's in the bar, go see him. So the Herdmans didn't have to stumble around the countryside. But I guess it wasn't like that for Imogene. For her, the Christmas pageant turned out to be all wonder and mystery, as if she just caught on to what Christmas is all about. After the pageant, we had a party in the basement, but the Herdmans didn't stay. They didn't have any cocoa, and they didn't walk off with all the cookies. They wouldn't even take their candy canes.
Well, I guess that's the last of them.
Everyone's gone. You know you have your bath robe on. Aren't you going to wear it?
Well, maybe. Why not? I wouldn't be mistaken for an angel in this choir or in this pageant.
Yes, you would. When it was over, some lady came up and hugged me because I was a shepherd. Should I bring this ham?
It's the Herman's ham. It's from their welfare basket, but they wouldn't take it back. Leroy said it was a present. You don't take presents.
Leroy said that? They must hate him.
You and Alice Wendelkin.
What about the lights?
They're on a timer, going off at midnight.
Actually, that's not too far away. It's almost Christmas.
It's almost Christmas, kids.